That long ago hour when her family boarded the Le Paris to flee a crazed Europe was one I so often made my mother describe that I virtually felt I had lived it. I had peered at a black and white photo of Roland in a small rented boat, a snapshot taken for her by a fellow passenger on the Le Paris deck, and I had wondered about him. On the back, neatly written, were the words, "Seul sur la mer," alone on the sea. And in the picture, Roland's thin face and angular features looked wooden, his expression as dark as the water around him. In a white shirt and tie and long overcoat, he appeared out of place in the nautical setting. Yet he was rowing behind the Le Paris as it made its way from the pier, bearing 448 Jews past the rosy stone forts at the mouth of the city's Vieux Port and out past the lighthouse to the glimmering Mediterranean Sea. It was afternoon when the Le Paris pushed away from the Quai de la Joliette, the sun floating toward the horizon as the ship passed beneath the promontory where the stately 19th century Palais du Ferro, built by Napoleon III, sits overlooking the water. There may have been dogs in the palace's park, running free in the grass, and lovers on benches enfolded in fervent embrace, just as you see there today, as boats of all sizes glided below, distant and toy-like, sails furled, motors purring, in and out of that pink twinkling harbor. Its beauty with a vast open ocean rich with the promise of freedom was entirely lost to Jeannine. In her arms, she clutched Roland's parting present, a fragrant bouquet of mimosas, tiny cottony yellow flowers that he had brought to the pier. In some parts of France, wearing yellow flowers had become a sign of sympathy for Jews forced to attach yellow stars to their clothing to mark them as outcasts. But Roland's carried another, more personal meaning. "Mimosas signify remembrance," he had whispered, his face in her hair, wild in the strong sea breezes when he clasped her to him before she embarked. The sunlit scent of the flowers surrounded the lovers in a space of their own on the fear-laden dock, as refugees swarmed all around them and elbowed each other to cross the gangway towards safety. When they parted, the bouquet seemed a token brought back from a dream and mocked her with all she had lost. And so, turning to the railing in tears as the ship picked up speed, she dropped the stems one by one to the water as if marking a luminous trail on the waves to find her way back to the man she adored. The flowers danced on the foam, drifted toward him, and caught on his oars, but the Le Paris soon left Roland behind, a speck on the water. The golden dots bobbed on the swelling surface around him as he rowed back alone to the land and its war.